I'm actually a computer and system engineer, so I have not really a background in education. And when I started having children, I have four children, four boys of my own, I stayed at home and then I became very involved with their schools. So I started doing all sorts of volunteering, PTA, all sorts of different activities. And then several principals in several schools just kind of said, hey, do you want to come work for us when my youngest was starting kindergarten? So at the beginning, I thought it was going to be just like a transition thing for me, and just because my youngest was coming to kindergarten. So I was like, okay, I'll do these when I go back to my career. But then I fell in love with it. So now this is what I do. So I'm a parent liaison and community liaison at a very special school. Our school is a sixth grade only, which there are not many of in the state. And besides that, what I was mentioning before, we have a very, very special, very unique system. And we're in the city of Marietta in Cobb County, and we have absolutely a little bit of everything. So we have a 73% poverty rate, but at the same time, we have, ridiculously bright children. We have kids from our high school that are going everywhere to MIT, to different schools. I mean, so you have everything. So you have to be able to serve not just the students, but their families. You have families that want to be there all the time at school, and people that have never set foot at school. So what makes our transitions very important is that we have to make sure that everybody is kind of, their needs are met. And so what I'm gonna do is we're gonna talk a little bit about what's transition and why it's important, and then I'm gonna show you a little bit of what we do. If at any point you have questions, please feel free. So transition, and I'm sure you all know, is a passing from a stage to another. And what brings anxiety during transitions is the unknown. So a lot of kids base their knowledge on what happens in middle schools on their older brothers. A lot of us as teachers and school personnel, we tend to be like in elementary school, you're not gonna be able to do that in middle school, you're not gonna be able to do that next year. They are not gonna allow you to do this anymore. So things like that kind of create anxiety in students. So we have to develop, at the school, we have to develop a great plan to ease all of those anxieties, not just on the students, but also on their families as well. So why are they anxious? Because the environment in general is more complex. Normally they're going to a small school, a small setting where they're more protected, to a larger campus, more classes, more options, you can see all I put there, and many more things, more rules, more expectations. So that creates a lot of anxiety. But how can we make this transition a good transition? It has to be all the time that you have in contact with the families and the students, has to be positive. So our principal always says, it's the first impression is the impression. It's like, that's the one chance you have to make an impression on somebody. So he's very concerned always about our smiles, and that he knows that I freak out until the day before. The day of is like a show. We call it the Disney day. You're smiling, you're not worrying about, because it's your first impression and it's gonna go a long way. You have to take in consideration all the stakeholders. Students, parents, teachers from fifth grade, and teachers that are going to be in contact with the children. And there are different needs, so there has to be a plan that is comprehensive of all these. You have to take into consideration that as you might have people with PhDs coming into school and kids that are straight A's, you might also have parents that don't know how to write or read, that don't know how to speak the language. So you have to really, it has to be meaningful. So you have to really look at your stakeholders and the people that you are. And this is, like, as I said, this is true for any school, but particularly for mine. Some schools are not as diverse as others. Every bit of information that you give has to be meaningful, because we tend to give tons and tons of paper that people throw, and then when it's something important, they just throw it as one more paper that came in the backpack or whatever. And it has to be timely when you rush things, and then you don't need, normally you give some information, it takes some time to be digested, and then people will come back with more questions, and so you can't wait until like the last minute to do it. So this is kind of what our plan looks like. So these are the logos of the eight, we have eight elementary schools that come into our 1-6 grade academy, and then we move from there to middle school and one high school. For our whole school, the purpose of our school is to get these kids ready for the rest of their school career. So we work on what Dr. Monty was saying, habits, transitions. We work on making them familiar with the new policies and new strategies. So for example, I'm gonna go over some of these events. For students only, you have to have, it's very important, a lot of schools have like what they call preview night or an open house or different activities for fifth graders when they come with all their families. We have one of those. But the question that a fifth grader will have is very different than the question that a fifth grade mom, the mom of a fifth grader will have. So the moms are more worried about maybe, you know, which classes, what's the score that you need to get into the most accelerated math, or what are the levels, how do you get into enhanced grammar, whatever. The students normally are, is it true that there are people that are going to get you in the bathroom? Or is it true, you know, can I play basketball and football at the same time? Do you have to change clothes for PE? Which are very, very valid questions. But when you put them with their parents, they get very, you know, they don't ask those questions, and then it adds to anxiety. So we have different activities. One of the things that we do is called the Show on the Road. The Show on the Road is because this is the first time, the first year, students are gonna have electives. So we offer two electives, one elective is in foreign languages, and one elective is in on the arts. So we have five options for the arts. And there are different requirements and different opportunities for each one of them. But what we do is we take little sampling of students from all the classes in ours, so band, drama, chorus, and we take them to each school. So we call this the Show on the Road, and we go, you know, you take a school bus and we go school by school showing what they have to look forward. This is when most students will ask questions. Like they are always administration talks, and they tell about the new rules, things that are different, the new schedule. And this is when students will start, let's see, like we have the little presentations, and then and then they will start asking questions to the administration. I think in my opinion, this is one of the most successful parts of the transition, because they start feeling like they belong, and that their opinion matters, and that they are taken into consideration. And a lot of things that have, like sometimes, you know, students will ask something and we're like, you know what, we haven't thought of that. Let us think that maybe we'll have it ready for next year. And we have done things like that, their suggestions have come into place in our school. The other big day that's for students is what we call the Blue Devil Day, and this is we invite all the fifth grade students. They all come with their school t-shirt, their field day t-shirt, and then they become because that class will graduate together. So this year we have the class of 2021. They will go together to the middle school and then move on to the high school. So we plan a field day with all the students will be mixed with other schools, and the fifth grade teachers also come. So in that way also, they feel like my teacher brought me, my teacher is making me help. The person they're seeing that they feel comfortable with is kind of walking them with, you know, with their hand. And they play all sorts of games. We do that with the whole PE department for the district. And then at the end, like the principal of the high school and the athletics director, like all these people from the different schools will come, and we do the shirting, which is everybody, you see all the schools with the different t-shirts, and then they will all receive a t-shirt that says class of 2021. So they look forward to that day. I mean, there are pictures, like these pictures in their agenda, they keep looking for themselves, and they're really cute. depends. You're really thinking of the child. What does the child need to feel comfortable? For me, in my opinion, for our school has the biggest blessing and the biggest kind of curse. We start working on these relationships since like January of the year previous. And then when you finally create a relationship with people, they move on. Mm-hmm. They leave and we start all over again. Which, you know, it has its good and its bad things. So what I was saying, it has to be timely. We send a letter at the beginning of the calendar year in January, which is 6 months before they go to our school. So we send the letter to parents, and all the information that we send is bilingual. We have a 40% Hispanic population. And it pretty much lays out like all the activities, you know, the activities that we're gonna have. We talk about the show on the road, the preview event, the whole day, and the opportunities for tours. We do tours every week for parents to all also ease them into our school, and we do small sessions of Q&A. So I think this is important because they can put in the calendar, it's timely, they know what's coming, what's going on. Obviously, we will, before each event, we will send reminders, we'll do little invitations, and
do they sign up for a particular time, or you just have a time, and then if they are interested, they show up at that time?
For the preview night, we do it, like, we do one night, that's the whole school. For the tours, I normally do tours Tuesdays, like, Tuesdays at 10. So, but normally they sign up so that we know they're coming. However, if anybody comes to our school, we're not going to turn them away. I'll try my best to help them. And one of, I think, the biggest events for this transition is the preview night. So this is when all the students from all the schools come into our school and we give them a preview of what's to come. I think the important link is like all the families come, but they come with their fifth grade teacher. So every classroom in our school will be one fifth grade teacher of the one fifth grade class of the district. So we, let's see, I have here the map, if you can see, like we will put like, for example, Lucky will be here, Sawyer Row will be, so every school will have three or four classrooms, which is equivalent to the fifth grade. They will be separated by fifth grade classrooms. So at the same time, the kids are seeing familiar faces, their fifth grade teachers, they are with the sixth grade teacher, they see that they're human, they're talking, they're either camaraderie, you know, in between them. And we plan a very, it's a very tight agenda, but it's very meaningful. So we start with Mr. Carmona, that's our principal, talking at in the gym, and he just gives general remarks. Then the parents get to see the band and the chorus and just kind of also give them that idea of what the opportunities the children will have. And then we go to our information, our general session. So they will be divided, they all get these and they all get which way they're going. And then we have a presentation that every teacher will do. For our Hispanic families, normally I stay in the gym and I said, if you would like to receive this presentation in Spanish, please stay in the gym and I'll be happy to do it, and we do the whole presentation in Spanish. That has been one of the things that people appreciate the most, because as a parent, you come, you're like, you're just following your kid, the kid's excited, but at the same time, you're not understanding anything. So, that day we introduce the electives, we give them the four. This year, we're doing it online with our online system. And it has worked out great, but they also have the opportunity, if they don't have a computer at home, to turn in a form. And we give them, you know, a lot of information about what they, normally people will know, like it's too much information to get it all that night, so a lot of documents they'll take home to read at a later time. The presentation, I'm not gonna go like over the whole thing, but it's huge, but we try to explain to them why do we, you know, all the new things that are different to them. Like, for example, it's a huge thing that kids don't need a note to be a car rider. They're shocked that they don't need a note if they're not going to be, if they're going to be a car rider. So we talk a lot about procedures and all the different things that are different in our school. And then they are allowed to go into into the self-guided tour. So everybody has a little tour and a map. And they can go and visit if they have questions about athletics. We have one place where it's athletics, another one where they, as you can see, parent involvement opportunities, technology. So in that way, they have another opportunity to go familiar with our school. Of course, there's tons and tons of papers they will receive that night. That's crazy. One of the most important things that parents appreciate is like, how is my child to be placed in the classes next year? So a lot of curriculum information comes at night. We have received great feedback. That's one of the things I have learned, that you always, everything that you do, you need to always ask for feedback. You don't know what's gonna come out of, you know, what people need and like, and sometimes you, just reassures you that you're, even if they say like something crazy, just reassures you also of the process that you're doing. And this is just pictures of that. Another thing that we do that, that we find that's very important is, as kids have different questions, parents are also very hesitant. They have a lot of questions. So we do, at the beginning, very beginning of the year, we do like a survey and ask them, what do you want to know about? How can we help you? And then based on those answers, we will develop, for example, workshops and different different strategies. One of the things that has come out of these has been the side-by-side activities, which is a class for parents and students. It helps a lot at this age for students to hear the same thing you're telling them as a parent from somebody else's mouth. So if I tell them, you guys need to sleep 9 hours, you always see the mom, see, I'm not crazy, I told you, you need to sleep. Little things, but they feel reassured. Parents feel reassured, and the students also are like, okay, so my mom's not crazy. So they have been very, very popular. And the thing is, every year, we have different sessions based on what the parents have asked. So, like this year, we not only have one that we do before, like with our fifth graders, which will be the transition to the middle grade child, about, you know, the amygdala line, why are they, you know, what Dr. Monty was mentioning, the hormones, they really are not meaning to be this way, but they can't help it. Their brain is developing in a different way, they need sleep, they need this. So, but we also get organized. They have come from most of their life to have had one teacher that has handled everything, to have seven, that each teacher is independent, and they're like, okay, this is a project, there is a project, there is a test, there is, and nobody's asking them, did you leave a project? Okay, so then I'm not gonna leave one. That doesn't happen in middle and high school. A lot of kids, they have been, through elementary school, they have been given the notes, given the study guide, given everything. So they don't know how to take notes, they don't know how to study. Some of us just learn when we get to college, but anyway. So anyway, it depends on what the parents want. We will give, like for example, this year we're doing one a lot about technology tools for both parents and students. How can you use technology to help you? That we haven't done before. And so this is kind of, this is an all survey, but we do different types of surveys, and then we'll give them an invitation. This invitation goes out after the first report card, like whenever we have conferences, because like if a child is doing badly, the parents are like, what can we do? It's like, well, let me invite you to this opportunity to sit with your child and learn how to do math, or you know, learn with your child how to get organized, or whatever. So, as I said, it has been a positive. We have been very positive classes. I noticed one thing. Normally, like people would come to the classes and they're very stiff, and as they go, like they're doing pandas in math and they're working with parentheses and whatever. They're closer and closer, and the kids, you can see the parents kind of touching, you know, hugging their kids, or being like, it is hard, or, you know, kind of being on their side a little. So that's very exciting. And locker day is huge. It's huge. Because they have never had a locker before. They're so excited, they're so afraid. There are a few tears every year because they can open it on the first. And then parents love to have an opportunity to be welcome and be helping at school. So we make a big deal out of it. I make them feel well, you know, send them videos and be prepared. And, you know, you're going to be there. They're not in a shining armor when they can open it. So some of them are like, can I come and practice before just in case I, you know, I was like, sure, keep coming, practice, open lockers. But that shows you, you know, the whole purpose is to lower that anxiety in what Dr. Monty was saying, create a relationship. From the point of view of a teacher and like in even as a parent liaison, I think one of the most important things though, it's timely response. When a parent calls, you need to respond those calls within 24 hours. When a parent emails you, even if you don't know, even if you need to talk to the administration, say, let me work on that, I'll talk to you, you know, I'll email you back soon. Whenever a parent like sends you an email and they don't hear from you one, 2 days, that's a relationship that you just, I mean, it will take a lot to bring that person back because they're like, okay, well, I offer, or like as a volunteer. If somebody tells me I want to help you and you never call them, what he was saying with the red box, it's my red box of volunteers. Even if it is counting papers or tallying surveys or say I have this huge mess, if you don't mind helping me, I need to reorganize, you know, I have like a supply, a room of supplies of donations. I'm like, if you don't mind helping me, I would love, that would be awesome, I would love it. But you always have to follow through in a timely manner is very, very important. The other thing that I have gotten, that we've gotten the most feedback about are the newsletters, and goes back again to timely, informative updates, I guess, and it's the newsletters. So I create two newsletters for the school. One is a weekly newsletter, the other one is monthly. Why one weekly, why one monthly? Because the weekly goes every week by email, and it's English only at this point. The monthly one, as its name says it, it goes once a month, it's bilingual, and it's more of a calendar of activities just for the people that don't have that access to email. Even though it's more often and more the people that have access than not. So this is what a newsletter looks like. So I normally have the first, well, let me go a little deeper here. Normally, the first thing that I do is this question, ask your child. A lot of times people don't know, like you ask your kid in middle grade, how was your school day?
Fine.
What did you learn at school?
Nothing.
So when you as a parent say, hey, do you know why the four categories of other authors pointless? It's like, no, I don't know. Well, maybe show us, find out, because, you know, I think that's one of your standards or whatever. That at least ignites that. Things like, hey, my mom is asking you about this, when are we gonna learn this? Or, and then the teacher can say, well, we're, you know, remember when we talk about this, or why don't you find out and share with the class or whatever. Even though these are all, even though these questions are taken from their standards, and it's like we will ask, every week I ask a teacher, okay, what did you guys learn today? This week is math, this week, next week will be science or whatever. So then we talk about our accomplishments as a school. So this is, you know, from different activities. We had a program, Marietta Reads, so we will put that. So the kids, the parents are not all, it creates that sense of community. Because parents will be like, oh, I saw your child was singing on Saturday, congratulations, and I noticed your kid was student of the month, or there is, because a lot of times we don't get that information out. So the parents will find out the kid was student of the month, or some of the students, but not the community in general. So we'll have, you know, their names, their little things. So it really gets them excited, and all the teachers find out about whatever other teachers are doing. So that's exciting. Like this student was in the newspaper. She was a Miss Preteen Miss North Georgia Fair. So that's the beginning of the newsletter. It's all of our kind of accomplishments. Then it's calendar. This is what's going on any week at my school. And then for planning out, so for planning purposes, because as I mentioned, I have four children of my own and four schools, I'm thinking of what will I like? What will be the perfect tool for me as a parent to have so I can plan my life? So we normally, I put like the four, I send it on Friday afternoon, so it will be the next week and the week after of information. Then parent opportunities. So all the opportunities, so the answer to the question right there in case parents don't know it. So I always put the answer to the question that I asked at the beginning, you know, in the parent opportunities. Then opportunities to volunteer and opportunities to do things for school. And then it comes to student opportunities. So anything, if there are clubs, taking applications, or if there are contests that we know of, we'll put all of this. And then other information on things that are happening around town. So as you can see, it's a pretty comprehensive, and this goes out every week. So parents really, you know, I have a lot of parents like, but it wasn't in the newsletter. And then the monthly one is a little bit smaller because I want to send it home, so it's in paper. So it's a one page, and the main things that are happening, and then it will have same thing, if big events that are happening in October and the following months, so people can also plan. I don't know if there are any questions so far. And then we also do, so all these, for families, we also do the tours and the small groups, Q&As. There are a lot of times we'll advertise like school by school so parents can come. In an ideal world, for example, if Georgia wasn't changing every year things, like I would love to have at the beginning of fifth grade a talk of where does your child need to be in order for the classes they want to take in sixth grade. So what scores they need in CRCT or in ITBS, what are the things that you need to be working on this year so that you're, because like if when you're going to high school, you know that you need to take, to be able to be in film one, you need to take pre-film, or if you need to be in drawing, you know, in drawing two, you need to be taking drawing one. So you're in charge of your choices. But a lot of times if we don't inform people, then they don't know what the opportunities are for them. This is another thing that it's a great opportunity to create a relationship. We send this an email to the principal. Our principal sends an email to all the principals in the elementary school saying, who are your big VIPs? Who are the people that are most involved in your school? Who are the parents that kind of move other people? And we invite them to come also and be like, hey, you're going to spread the word, and you know, what can we do for you? And they become our first, you know, like our, they become the one on the street. So it's people that have been maybe in PTA before, or they have been room parents, or sometimes it's the people that the hard to handle parents. We invite them so that we have them on our side from the beginning. So they come in May and we say, okay, well, this is what we are. We have like a little school store, which is the most sought after place because it's run by parents, and everybody wants to work a school store. And obviously we hype it up and we're like, we're taking names for next year's school store, and already have people for next year. I think, you know, the last stop of this transition, because all of this has happened before they even get to be our sixth graders. Well, except Mother Day, obviously. It's meeting, we have another event when they will come and get their schedule. They'll have the opportunity to be their teachers, find out what's their boss route, all these things, you know, like a meet and greet for our school. So what we develop is we have like a scavenger hunt. So they have like different stops and we're like, okay, visit your guidance class and see, okay, what's the name of your advisor? What's the number of your classroom? Now next, follow your schedule, go do this, meet your teacher. So they go and they kind of check their stops along the way. They go and buy their uniforms. They go, so it's a little fun. It's like, okay, where are you? Which one are you having? Oh, well, go ahead and go to, I don't know, the bus routes, it's empty right now, and again, we give them maps and all sorts of activity. It's pretty fine. You're gonna see here in the pictures. People look crazy. They're like, oh, it's like they're so excited to be looking for all the little things in the scavenger hunt. And again, you know, we give them tons of different information that they. It's important. I know nobody reads a lot of stuff, but at least if somebody wants to go back and read it, they can find it. And then to finish, we do an open house later on when school has already started. And it's to give parents the opportunity to be a day in the life. For me, as a parent, that was one of the events when my oldest child was in sixth grade. It kind of gave me the most perspective because I went and I tried without a backpack and without everything to just kind of be in his schedule. And it was a lot to be running from Bayonne to France to German, and then, you know, it was just the magnitude of the place just gave me some understanding of what he went through every day. So I really liked that. It was very, and one thing that we also do to help with this transition and the way that students take responsibility for their education is that our conferences are led by the students. So we, our students are the ones that present, present to the parents, and they'll have a script and they say, "Thank you, Mom, for taking the time and coming to my conference." And we build all sorts of different documents, which I don't know why the link is not working, but they have a script that they will say, like, "I'm doing my best in math because I have good habits," or "because I'm working hard," or whatever. "I could be doing better in French, turning in my homework on time." So they have a little guide to, but so that saying, "This is what I'm doing, this is what I need to be working on." We developed this passport, which is like it has all the goals for the district, the goals for the school, and then the goals for the student itself. So so this is what I was. These are my grades, which you really can't see, but over here we put their grades, and then what's my goal for next quarter, what am I working on? And then over here, all the habits. Am I turning in my work? Am I coming prepared? So they'll say, "Yes, always, sometimes, do I need to be working on?" And then these are standardized tests in CRCT. We do the MAP, which is a national standardized test. So same thing, what are my scores? What are my goals? Am I on track to graduate? So that's the, like, so far, as a sixth grader, am I on track to graduate? And then we give them all the passwords and users for all the different tools that we use at school, that are available for them. And then in the back, as I was saying, we give them, okay, these are the titles for side-by-side, workshops, these are another resources, you know, anything from Khan Academy and the Homework Hotline, Atlanta Homework Hotline to web pages from the teachers. So it gives them, like, my kids keep theirs, like, in the refrigerator, and it has all the information that as a parent you will need. So again, it's all like information that's meaningful. For teachers, we meet with all the fifth grade teachers, and we create data walls of all the students that are in RTI process, all the students that have different needs, and they're all sitting at different times so that we are very informed of where our students are so we can help them from day one. So we don't wait until, you know, they transition to sixth grade. We're starting to meet in fifth grade so that they're ready for us. And then we try to do teaming, which is we have little teams of like 6-1, 6-2, where there are core teachers, math, science, social studies, and language arts, share a team. So they feel each like in a mini school instead of having to go throughout the whole building. And to finish, I'm gonna just kind of show you a little video of what some of our parents have said about the transition process.
Well, actually, twins who were here, and they could not be more different. And they have both had a fantastic experience. And what I love about it is it really is geared toward helping children make that transition from elementary school into navigating the world more on their own. and they all get to come together and get to know each other in an environment that is designed specifically for them. So it's a great academic environment, but what I really like most about it is it teaches respect and understanding, and it gives them a chance in this unique building to really get to know each other before they then move on to some of the bigger pressures that come in the higher middle grades and in high school.
What I really like about Marion Sixth Grade Academy, MSGA, is the transitional focus that it has as the kids are leaving elementary school and as they're preparing to go into the middle school. That has really been a great benefit to my daughter as she attends here. It gives her time to mature into that middle school that she soon will be. I also like the sense of community that the school has, whether it be the students, the faculty, or the staff, how people come together and work together for the overall success of the young people. That's something that appeals to me not only for the Sixth Grade Academy, but for Marietta schools in general. The reason we moved to Marietta 12 years ago was for the school system, and we haven't regretted it one bit.
The funny part about these videos is that they weren't asked to talk about transitions or anything. They just said, they were parents that said, hey, you know, how has been your experience with the MSGA? And they interviewed like 4 or 5 parents to do these little videos. And I thought it was pretty funny that all of them, even the ones that didn't make it into the final cut, they talk about the transitions. So when I was very excited when I was invited, because this is what I do every day, and I can see how our school has changed, not just the school itself, but the community, the sense of community that has created, and how people have come together and continue together, starting in that through that transition. So, if you don't have any questions.
Yeah, I do, but I want them to ask first.
I was just going to ask, was the Sixth Grade Academy established?